So I'm going to show you why working in the browser with SharePoint is the best way to be working with your files. So what I've got here is a document library. A document library is a part of SharePoint sites. It's where files get stored to from when you're using Teams. It's basically the storage container for default for the files you're working on in SharePoint. Now, the SharePoint site can contain a number of folders, but at the site SharePoint document library level, there's a number of different functionality that you can add that will flow through all the way to the bottom of each file that's stored in that library. I'm not going to get into a lot about that. There's some other videos that you can look at how to take advantage of that, but let's just take a look at the basics. So I'm going to open up my folder here, and I have options where I can upload files. So just like you normally would, I can upload multiple files or folders that contain files and load that information all up here. Now, when it comes time to start working with files and stuff, under the new, there are the new folder, but I can create a brand new Word document or Excel or PowerPoint or OneDrive, and it gets stored directly in SharePoint. Now keep in mind, SharePoint is cloud computing. It is the Microsoft land. So the files that I create here are going to allow me to share these files with other people who are also using Microsoft 365. That's the basics of this. So here's my document. It's pretty straightforward. I'm just going to put in some text here, blah, 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 blah. And I'll call this my new document. And we'll open it up. Now, the browser version of Microsoft Word has a lot of functionality, but not all of it. It's the same thing with Excel and PowerPoint. There's a lot of basics that are in there. Quite often when Microsoft is adding artificial intelligence stuff to their products, they will start in the browser first before they go to the desktop. One of the things that challenges people is they don't like this look. They want their standard look, and that's fine. Under the editing piece here, I can just click on this and I can open this file in the desktop app. So what it does is it communicates with the Microsoft cloud, the file that's stored in the cloud, and it opens it up directly in that file that's in the cloud within here in this document. And here you'll notice we're back to Microsoft Word and everything's exactly the same as I had before. The difference being is that this is auto-saved. It's not saved to my desktop. It is auto-saved to the SharePoint file stored in the cloud. So any changes I make or anyone else makes is automatically saved. Using the desktop syncing, there's actually a temporary file that gets stored on your computer. And Microsoft kind of goes, well, okay, you make changes, I'll put them on this temporary file. Then I'll take the temporary file, make the changes up into the cloud. And that's where we have syncing problems in. So when you work directly with the file, all the changes are saved automatically straight to the cloud. This also means that you can have multiple people using this document at the same time. And not just on the same view, but I could be on page 1, someone else could be on page 10, someone else could be on page 37. So we're still working on the same document. There's only one document. And it doesn't matter whether I'm using the browser or the desktop app. If I've connected to this file that's stored directly in the cloud, it's going to sync the changes. And then you're not going to have the syncing and error problems that you've had in the past. So I'll close this window, go back to my page here, and I'm just going to go close all these documents here. Close to the right. And we'll take a look at this same file. There's my new document. Now, before, when you just clicked on this, it just opened up in the browser. When I click on the menu here, I could right click. It's the same thing. But under open, it says open in app. And what that does is exactly what you think it does. It opens it up in Microsoft Word. It skips the step of opening it into the browser first. So again, bang, we're right there, right into Microsoft land, and off we go and running. Should I need to make a copy or create a new file? I can do that from Word still. I'll go under File, and in this case, I'm going to save a copy. Now, Microsoft still remembers that, hey, the original file was stored in this site here. I can save it right there. But if I was just to go and create a brand new document, so let me just open up Word again, since it disappeared on me. But I'm going to create a brand new document, and we'll use this one for the heck of it. I'll create it. And when it comes time to save this, and I'm only saving it for the first time, here's my options. I can go into my sites. So these are all the different sites that I'm a member of, whether as a Google group or within Microsoft Teams. But I could go in, work my way down, find the place I want, which was number 10 here. Let's get there in a second. Open it up there. There's all my other stuff. And I'll type it in here, second document. Save it. And now that file is stored again in the cloud. So we take advantage of that Office 365 the technology goodness. And I just need to do a quick refresh here. It'll eventually will load, but sometimes I just need to do a refresh. And there's the second document right there. And everything still applies to 365 that we talked about before. All right, I'm going to open up this second document. I'm going to open it again. And this time I'll open it in the directly in the desktop app. Now, I want to share this file. Up in the top right-hand corner, I go click on it and share it. This will allow me to go and send it to a person by email or by someone that's already in the Microsoft contact list. When I share it, I can choose what access I want to give that person, so whether they can edit or view. If I send this to an external person that's got an external Microsoft account, I can do that, but it will only share externally for 100 days, something to keep in mind. The other thing, though, that I can do is I can send a copy of this. Now, when we send off through here, we're sending a link to that document stored in the cloud, which means one copy, we all work on it. We don't have to worry about who's got the most recent updates because we're only working on one document. But sometimes you might want to send this person a copy of the file. When you send a copy of the file, it's going to use Outlook. It's going to convert and either send it as a Word document or PDF. So I'm going to send this a PDF. It automatically converts it to PDF. It will now use Outlook without my actually having to go into Outlook. Pull up a window here, and there's my message. I can include whoever I want to go to. I can change the name of the file, and then there's the attachment as a PDF. Bang, off it goes, and then that file is now going to be sent off as a copy to the end user. Speaking of email, when we're looking at files and uploading files here, I can use the, unselect this, I can use the upload function. I can also, from my files, file explorer, I can also click and drag a file. So if I go into my downloads, if there's something there, I can actually just grab this, drag it down into here. Let me try that again. Here we go. And it will automatically upload to my SharePoint. So I don't have to use upload, I can just drag and drop from the desktop. I can also drag and drop the attachment from Outlook. So you remember that Outlook attachment, if I receive something like that, I can click and drag from there onto this window and bang, everything's gonna upload automatically.